गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द रेपर ट्रांजेक्शन। सो इन नट सेल वट इज रेपर ट्रांजेक्शन। सो माई डियर स्टूडेंट, रेपर ट्रांजेक्शन डिफिनेशन कैन बी इन वन लाइन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सी दैट इट इज द प्रोसेस बाई विच लॉजिकल इलिमिनेशन ऑफ अपेरेंटली सिमिलर मेडिसिन इज डन। What it means? It is a process by which logical elimination of apparently similar medicine is done. It means when you will do rapid transition, what you will do? You will do case taking, followed by analysis and evaluation, followed by rapid transition. So, my dear students, what you done repertorization. Repertorization, after that what you do? You will get a group of remedies having different type of a score and different type of covering symptom. So what you will do now? You will choose one remedy among these possible outcome of repertorization. But why this possible outcome came by repertorization? Because you are using a logical elimination of other possible symptom. What is logic? It may be deductive logic, it may be inductive logic. In our previous class I have told you that in relation to Organon and repertory, that one question which is very common also in Organon also in repertory, that is logic in homeopathy. So in that question you have to understand that what is logic, who is father of logic, who is what is deductive logic, what is inductive logic, and all these things can be summarized in short notes which I will discuss in a separate lecture. So my dear students, here logical elimination is the main thing, primary thing. Second thing, of apparently similar medicine. Logical elimination of apparently similar medicine, because after repertorization you will find at least 5 to 10 drugs. If you are covering at least 5 to 6 symptoms, then you will find at least 10 drugs or 5 drugs which are covering all of your symptoms. But you will always not prescribe the first drug coming or top scoring drug in repertorization. Even after repertorization, you will try to eliminate other drugs which came as a result of repertorization. So in whole repertorization you are doing logical elimination from apparently similar medicine for that particular case which you are repertorizing at that moment. In nutshell, you can say narrow down the field of selection. Narrow down the field of selection, it mean that you have a lot of drugs in materia medica, but what drug you are choosing, it become easy to choose from 10 drugs in compared to choosing from even if you are using boric materia medica or LN, then 180 plus drugs. You are using boric, then 1400 plus drug. So it is become easier to select for final to go to step of final selection by the process of repertorization. But if this question comes in your university exam, then I will suggest you to go through Sasi Kantiwari sir book, and there you will find exact definition which you have to write in exam. What you have to write in exam?
द प्रोसेस ऑफ रिपर्टराइजेशन इज इसेंशियली ए लॉजिकल इलिमिनेशन ऑफ अपेरेंटली सिमिलर मेडिसिन एंड इट स्टार्ट्स विद ए ब्रॉड चॉइस एंड ग्रेजुअली नैरोज डाउन द फील्ड विच प्रोवाइड अस ए एडिक्वेट एंड ए स्मॉल ग्रुप ऑफ सिमिलर मेडिसिन सो दैट द फाइनल सिलेक्शन ऑफ सिमिलम इज ईजियर एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ फर्दर रेफरेंस टू द मटेरिया मेडिका इफ रिक्वायर्ड. सो वॉट डॉक्टर शशिकांत तिवारी सर सेज दैट सेम थिंग इट मीन इसेंशियल लॉजिकल इलिमिनेशन सेम थिंग. Still, it narrows down your field and then final consultation with MM. So it is a repertorization. And one more thing that the aim of repertory is never to replace materia medica. The aim of repertory is never to replace materia medica. Now, it is just repertorization. Now I will discuss with you that one question which is very important for MCQ point of view, that what is classical method of repertorization. So I will request you to pause the video and write your answer in comment section. So and then come back and see the answer. So it is a very common question. It is asked in many exam many times. So I will suggest you all to reply and try and must remember this question. So what is answer? Its answer is plain paper method. What is answer? Plain paper method is classical method of repertorization. So now one more question comes which is not very important, but even if it is asked still in your MCQ, then what you will reply you must know, that what is modern method of repertorization. So what is modern method of repertorization? Again, I will request you to pause and see what you can answer, and then in your comment you try to answer, and then again cross check by continuing video. So I will request you all to just pause and write your answer. What is modern method of repertorization? Okay. repertory seat method. Now, few of the students will question that, sir, how you were saying that repertory seat method is modern method of repertorization? And today, we have a lot of software. We have even card repertory and many type of software repertory and auto visual repertory. So, why you are saying this as repertory seat method is modern method of repertorization? My dear students, whatever method you are applying, whatever method you are applying, maybe it may be computer repertory, it may be any software, it may be mobile repertory, it may be auto visual repertory, or whatever method, you are indexing your drug in repertory seat. It may be direct, it may be indirect, but you are using repertory seat. Second thing, why you are saying classical method of repertorization is plain paper method. So, in our class, when we will try to make a one day workshop, like where we will try to repertorize a case in plain paper method, and it will take approximately 2 to 3 hours. So first we will try to do one case repertorization by repertory seat method. In our practical class we will take it, and then we will again go to next step, that is plain paper method of repertorization. But it will take at least 2 hours, as it will be our first case to repertorize. So, my dear students, what are benefit of repertory seat method and plain paper method? Both are totally different. And what are benefit, what are merit, what are demerit, I will discuss you in further class. But you must know that plain paper method is classical method, and if you are repertorizing any case by this, then what will happen? You will be become master. At least if you are doing 10 to 100 cases, you will become master in repertorization of near about every type of cases. Why? Because if you are doing 100 cases, then you will know that how to prepare repertory seat. In repertory seat, you will get repertory seat prepared, already prepared repertory seat. But if you are doing plain paper method, then what will happen? You will get a plain paper in which you have to prepare your own repertory seat. You will get a plain paper in which you have to prepare your own repertory seat. So what will happen? By doing plain paper method, you will prepare everything. So what is benefit? The most beneficial part of it, that you will not be predetermined with repertory seat. You will not be just like if you are working from ground zero, then you will know that what type of mistakes can occur at what step. So, my dear students, at least 10 cases we will try to repertorize by plain paper method. And second thing, that you will know the abbreviation of every drug when you will prepare repertory seat. You will know if in any case you are scoring or covering more than 10 or 11 symptoms. If in any case you are covering more than 10 or 11 symptoms, and all, suppose you are using 12 symptoms, you are using 13 symptoms, and all the symptoms are essential for scoring that case, then normal repertory seat have नॉर्मल रेस्पिरेटरी सीट है अप्रॉक्सीमेटली 10 to 11 सेंटर स्पेस, बट इफ़ यू आर यूजिंग प्लेन पेपर मेथड देन यू कैन कवर वॉट एवर नंबर ऑफ सिम्टम यू वॉन्ट और वॉट एवर नंबर ऑफ सिम्टम रिक्वायर्ड बाई दी केस. सो प्लेन पेपर मैथड हैव नो लिमिटेशन ऑफ सिम्टम्स टू बी कवर्ड, वाई इफ यू आर यूजिंग रेपर्टरीशिप मैथड यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर ए रेपर्टरी प्रैक्टिकल रिकॉर्ड फाइल फॉर योर फाइनल ईयर एग्जामिनेशन. यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर ए रेपर्टरी रिकॉर्ड फाइल, प्रैक्टिकल रिकॉर्ड फाइल, इन विच यू हैव टू रेपर्टराइज फ्यू नंबर ऑफ एक्यूट केसेस एंड फ्यू नंबर ऑफ क्रॉनिक केसेस. सो इन एक्यूट केसेस यू मे रिक्वायर लिस्ट नंबर ऑफ सिम्टम, बट इन क्रॉनिक केस कवरिंग ए लॉट ऑफ वराइटी ऑफ सिम्टम और मल्टीपल ऑर्गन प्रॉब्लम यू मे रिक्वायर, माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू मे रिक्वायर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ सिम्टम बिलोंगिंग टू डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पैथोलॉजी और डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ बॉडी, और यू मे गेट अलोंग विद मैनी अदर जनरल सिम्टम. सो इन दैट केस, इन दैट सिनेरियो व्हाट विल हैपन, यू मे बी मोर देन 11 सिम्टम. आई एम जस्ट शोइंग यू वन रिपर्टरी सीट. Like this, few students have met their this in chart. So I will show you in future ideal repertory sheet, and I will give you. And in that ideal repertory sheet, you will get a number index of symptom, name, identification, mark of patient, and then generally in our NIH, UG and PG life. What repertory sheet we were provided was covering 11 symptoms and then marking of drugs was continued. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So in our NIH repertory sheet we were using 11 symptoms. So in exam you have to use repertory sheet hard copy where you have to repertorize. So but if you are using at least 2 or 3 cases plain paper, then you will be accustomed with how to prepare repertory sheet and what are drawbacks. So thank you dear students. In next class we will discuss all the working method of repertorization, followed by we will discuss different method of repertorization, then we will discuss steps of repertorization, and then we will do one practical case of repetition. Thank you dear students.